Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to use Event Grid and Azure Automation to automate purging data from an Azure CDN. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Seraltos. In this video I'm going to walk you through setting up a workflow in Azure using Event Grid and Azure Automation. For the example, I'm going to run an automation to purge content from an Azure CDN cache every time new content is uploaded or deleted from the source. This video has two takeaways. First, if you want to quickly purge outdated content from an Azure CDN, this video is going to show you how to do that. Second, if you want to see how to integrate Event Grid and Azure Automation for workflow automation, keep watching. The interesting thing about Event Grid is it works with multiple Azure services. The automation shown in this video can be applied to those services as well. Before we move on, please take a second to subscribe. It's a simple process and it's 100% painless. In my previous video, I walked through setting up an Azure CDN. I'll post a link to that someplace up here. This demo picks up where the last one left off. Once content is cached across the globe, it can take time for newly published content to replace the old. To speed up the process, we use the purge feature to clear files from the cache so new content can replace it. This example is going to show you how to automate that process with Event Grid and Azure Automation. Here's the flow overview for the automation. Content is uploaded or removed from the content source, in this case, blob storage. The upload or delete event will trigger Event Grid. Event Grid fires a webhook to an Azure Automation runbook, passing details about the event in JSON format. The runbook parses the JSON and runs the purge operation against the file that was added or removed. If you're not familiar with Azure Automation, I have a whole playlist of setting up and using it. Link above. Enough chit-chat, let's move on to the demo. Buckle up everyone, it's demo time. So in this demo, I'm gonna cover creating a runbook and a webhook. Then I'm gonna configure Event Grid on the storage account to use that webhook. After that, I'm going to build the runbook to actually purge the content. And then we're gonna do some testing. So with that, let's move on. The first step in this process is going to build the actual runbook. And I need to do that first because I need the webhook for the Event Grid. So I'm gonna build this runbook with some pretty simple content in it for now, then come back later and actually build out the full runbook. So I'm gonna go to runbooks, I'm gonna create. Let's call this one CDN purge. And for the runbook type is gonna be PowerShell. And I'll click create. Now I'm going to edit that. And we're going to call, just do a write output. And again, this is just a placeholder for the actual content I'm going to put in. But I need to gather some information first before I can build that out. So I'm going to click save. And we'll publish. And then I'm going to add a webhook. So I need the webhook in place before I can set up the Event Grid trigger because the webhook is the actual action. So let's go in here and we'll call this CDN purge webhook. It's going to be enabled and I'll set this for a year out. Remember that this will expire on the date and it'll quit working. Now I've got some stuff blocked out on my screen. But here is the URL. So this URL is important. Once we get done creating this webhook, we won't be able to go in and retrieve this value. So I don't care that you really see that one. I'll just paste that into Notepad, save that for later. Then I'm going to click OK. Now I'm going into Modify Run Settings. And if there were any parameters for this runbook, they would be here. And we're going to go to run settings. If I wanted this to run on like a hybrid worker, I could set that here, but that's not the case. So I'll simply click OK and create. That's going to create the webhook. So now that webhook that I just created and copied will trigger this runbook. Next, I'm going to go over to my storage account. Let's just go back. This is the CDN I set up in my previous video. I'm going to go into the storage account and we're going to go to events. Now I have nothing configured, so I'm going to go here. There's Azure Logic Apps and Functions and More Options. Under More Options is Webhook. And that's what we want. So I'm going to call this CDN Purge. We'll call it CDN purge event. I'm going to keep the schema. Here you can see that the topic type is a storage account and the resource is the storage account. And under event types, there's two options. There's blob create and blob delete. I'm going to leave these the same, but you could change them if you needed. Now I'm going to go to the endpoint type and select webhook. Next, I'm going to select an endpoint. And here's where I'm going to paste in that URL. So what this is saying is that if any new content is added or deleted, it's going to trigger this webhook. And I'll click create. Now if I go back up and look at event subscriptions and refresh, here you can see this CDN purge event. You can also see a couple other ones that I have here from testing, but you can ignore those for now. So what I want to do is test this again to make sure that it's working as I expect. I also need some JSON data that's passed into the runbook. So let's do that. Let's first test by going over to Storage Explorer, and I'm going to copy, just going to simply copy the index.html in, and there it goes. So that just ran a copy, which is going to create a new file on the storage account. If I go in here, it's going to take it a couple seconds to show up, but I'm going to come back to my runbook. And if I refresh the runbook, you can see a job is queued. So what happened is I uploaded content into that storage account. That triggered the event in Event Grid, which then kicked off the webhook, which ran this runbook. And we can go in now that it's complete. And if we look at output, it worked, as it says here. So that webhook triggered this runbook. Now, what I'm really interested in is the webhook data. If I click here, I can copy and paste all this information into a JSON file. We can take a peek at it. And I like to format just so it's a little bit easier to read. So here's the data that Event Grid is passing into the runbook. And under request body, we scroll all the way over here towards the end, you can see a URL. Now, when I run the purge operation, I need to tell it what file to purge. What this is telling me is source/index.html is the file that I want to purge. So that's the value of URL. So what I'm going to do is grab this from the JSON, strip off the fully qualified domain name, and that will leave the path that I need to run the purge operation. Let's look at the actual runbook that I'm going to use to do that. So if I start here, you can see I've got my purge CDN runbook. I've got some notes up on top. I do have this available on my GitHub page. I'll post a link below. You can go in and download it and take a look at it as you like. So the first thing I'm going to do is grab the webhook data, the JSON data that's passed in with a parameter. The next thing I'm going to do in this runbook is authenticate, because this runbook has to authenticate to Azure in order to have permission to run the purge operation. And if you're not familiar with Azure Automation and runbooks, I have a whole playlist on it. I'll put a link up top. You can go ahead and go back and look those over, and should get you up to speed on Azure Automation and runbooks. The next thing I'm going to do is assign some values to variables. So I've got the profile name, the resource group, and the endpoint name, all of the CDN. I also assign a value of the error action preference to a variable, and I use that later for error correction. The next thing I have here is I'm going to convert the request body information from that webhook data and assign that to a variable of request body. And I've got try catch blocks in here, so if anything goes wrong, the catch block is going to capture the error message and write that to the error stream. If you're interested in learning more about error handling and try-catch blocks, there's a great ebook on powershell.org on how to do that. Okay, next is the convert the request body to a file path. Here you can see is requestbody.data.url. So that's the URL that I showed you before from the JSON. And I've got a simple replace command that's going to take the HTTPS and then the fully qualified domain name and replace that with nothing. So it's basically just stripping it out. And if you're doing this at home, you would have to update this string with your own information. That's going to assign the actual file path and file name to the file path variable. And at the end is the actual command, the unpublished-azcdn endpoint content. That's going to actually run the purge command. So with that, I'm going to copy all this and just paste it into that runbook. There are other ways to update runbooks, but this is going to be the way I do it today. So I'll save and publish that. One other note, because I just thought of it, I'm using the unpublish AZ CDN endpoint content command, which is an AZ command. So it's the new Azure module. If you create a new Azure Automation account, it's probably going to still have the Azure RM. So if you have not updated your Azure Automation account to the AZ commands, you will need to use the change that in the script to Azure RM instead of AZ. And also, if we come back to the automation account and go to modules, you can see I have the az.cdn module that does need to be imported for this to work. So again, if you're using the AZ set in Azure Automation, you want to import the az.cdn. If you're still using Azure RM, you'll want to import Azure RM.cdn. You can do that through the module gallery. You can see it has both of them listed here. And all you have to do to import them is click on it and import. Okay, so let's get back to where we were before. So I'm in the runbooks. I have CDN purge published. And now I want to give it a try to see if it'll work. I'm going to go back into the storage. And again, I'll upload that file. It's going to run a replace. And there, it's complete. So now if I come back, let's just see if it shows. There's the first one we ran. Let's come back into my runbooks. I'm going to go into CDN Purge, the runbook that we just created and updated. And here you can see the job is queued. So that tells me that Event Grid saw that content was uploaded and it triggered the webhook to run. Now it's running. This is going to take a couple minutes to run. So I'm just going to pause here and I'll get back once it's done. So that job is complete. Let's go in and take a look. We can see it passed in the JSON data. There's no output for this job, and under errors, we have none. And under all logs, there's nothing. So let's go back to our storage account. You can see there is the one that just ran. In resource groups, I'm going to go to CDN endpoint and activity log. Here we can see a purge operation was ran. It was accepted 4 minutes ago, started 4 minutes ago, and succeeded 2 minutes ago. So this tells me that the purge operation was successful. And we have a working automation now so that every time content is uploaded to or deleted from the CDN, the purge operation is going to run. So that does it for the demo. Thanks everyone for watching. I hope you found this useful and informative. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.